Okay, coaches, I am pleased to be able to come to you this morning and talk to you a little bit about football. I know it's kind of a weird situation here with everybody being quarantined, and it's kind of nice to be able to sit back and chat a little bit of football. Want to give a shout out and appreciation to the Football Coaches Association for giving me an opportunity to talk to you today about single wing. So we're going to get right into it. This first page, of course, is got my contact information. By all means, feel free to give me a call at any time. And what I want to talk to you today about is something that I've kind of been passionate about over the last 2 years, really 1 year of installation and a second year of implementation, and that is the single wing. And the I want to kind of do a disclaimer and kind of let you know that I haven't been doing this very long. So the stuff I'm going to show you today is really stuff that that we've just been doing here for 1 year at Pawpaw High School. And all of these clips and all this information I'm going to show you is just 1 year of doing this. So this is really a new thing for me as a head coach. And I want to try to promote it, I guess, and kind of share with you how it's been a good fit for our system. So let's go ahead and get into it. I want to do a few seconds and talk to you about my background. I have 30 years coaching experience at the high school level. Most of my coaching has been done in the southwestern Michigan area. I've had stops at Climax Scotts and Vicksburg, Ione Public Schools, Bangor, Mattawan twice. I was at Mattawan and then left to be a head coach at Bangor, and then came back to Mattawan for 6 years. And then most recently, I've been coaching at Pawpaw High School for the last 4 years. And for those that don't know where Pawpaw is, it's a smaller school, suburb of Kalamazoo. We play Division IV football. Anyways, I've coached at all levels, assistants and head coaches between 9th grade and 12th grade. Most of my time has been as an offensive coordinator. So I say that just because I've been through a lot of different systems. I've seen a lot of different types of philosophies of offense, from spread sets to veer football, to option football, and really quite a gamut of different systems and belief systems. And having said that, what I'm doing right now is, and for the past, I guess probably going on 10 years or so, is I've been running the power T or the wing T. And I started running the T football at Mattawan High School in 2009. And then I've been running it ever since, both through the years at Mattawan and also at Pawpaw. Now, the reason that I run the wing T, and for those of you that are wing T guys out there, these are probably things that you can relate to. You know, I kind of believe, well, number one, I believe in it. I think it's going to go ahead and equalize talent. I think it slows teams down. I think that people have to play assignment-free football or assignment football. I think that T football is the best offense out there that really helps give you an advantage over undisciplined athletes. You have to be very disciplined to play against T football. It's very difficult to defend. And to simulate. I know that when I was playing against T football and we had to come in and have 1 week to prepare, it was very difficult for scout teams and things like that. Deception is a big part of wing T philosophy, and I think that misdirection and counter game and deception football, finding the ball, very, very hard. I think it's one of the things that gives us a lot of advantage. T football is very ball controlling. It can be very demoralizing for athletes. The other thing, which I think is really big, is that T football breeds physicality. And I think that some of these teams today that are more spread oriented and are dealing with you know, passing the game or passing the football around. Really, they miss out on some of the physicality of the game. And I think that you don't have that luxury in a T football. You're always getting off the ball with physicality. And so, those are some of the reasons why I believe in the T. And I'm not here to really talk about T football too much. I'm here to talk more about single wing, but I wanted to give you a little background as why I do what I do. Wing T for me was really a leap of faith before I started running it 10 years ago, 10, 11 years ago. I literally had no prior experience. I was used to more of a spread system and was used to running multiple sets and was really into the jet sweep packages at that time period and really shotgun type of formations. And the reason I changed my offensive system was because when I went to Mattawan, I just knew that school needed to have a little bit of a change. And the reason I mention that is because number one, I had to do a lot of research when I first started. And when I'm talking to you today about the single wing, you know, if anybody has any interest in implementing that into your system, I would say that that's something you really, really have to do. When I brought a run philosophy, package into both Mattawan and Pawpaw, I got a lot of resistance. A lot of people told me that, T won't work. It's boring to watch and, we don't like it cause you're not throwing the ball around. And the bottom line is that, as a football coach, I think you have to stay the course on what you believe in. And, staying the course and believing in your system and training your lower levels to do the same thing as the varsity, I think that's super important. And I think over time it's going to breed success. And we're really locked in now to what we do at Pawpaw. And a lot of criticism now has met with a lot of success, and success is always the great proves to the critics that you know what you're doing. Anyways, moving on. This is my base offensive formation. It's just the T. I'm not going to spend a ton of time on this, but this is what I do most of the time. I would say my offensive package, we are probably in this set 80% of the time. We run most of our stuff out of this. Now, we do once in a while break away from the T. These are some of our variations of formations. Our T package is our package with no name. So if I call a play out there, our guys are just going to line up in a straight T. We get into a wing over there. We have a right and a left formation. And then, once in a while, we'll run a double wing set. We'll run a strong set that you see down there. And really, most of the season, these are the formations that we're kind of in. Now, as far as plays, going back a slide, we are like most T teams, most offenses, period. We have A gap attack and B gap and C gap and D gap attacks. This is what we're trying to run in our offense. We're trying to run, middle traps. We're trying to run bellies and inside powers to B gap. We're trying to run counters and off tackle J plays or power plays into C gap. And then we're trying to run tosses and sweeps and keeps to D gap. So this should be no surprise to anybody. I think every good offense is going to be able to attack each gap in different spots. And this is basically what we're doing. The T for me has been very successful. I took over a program at Mattawan High School in 2009 that was 1-8. Through the course of the 6 years I was there, we had tremendous success. It took a few years. I think our first year we were 2-7, and then we went 3-6, and then we started winning a lot of football games. So, you know, over the years, we, over those 6 years, we qualified for the playoffs, three of the 6 years. We were champions, league champions in 2011 and district champions in 2012. So again, very successful, there running this system. Pawpaw, which I went to Pawpaw in 2015, been there 4 years. And again, total overhaul of the offense. Pawpaw was a real spread system at the time, and we've had some success over the course of 4 years. And last year we were fortunate enough to qualify and win the district championship, and hopefully we'll have more success in the future. Now, so that's a little bit of background of the tee, but what I really want to talk to you about is adding the single wing to that tee package. And a couple years ago, like anything, I was at a, you know, I was looking for wrinkles and things to do that maybe were a little different. And I was fortunate enough to sit in on a clinic that talked about the single wing football. And I had very, again, no knowledge, and really, or I should say limited knowledge of single wing football. And I sat down on a, you know, Saturday morning at the Football Coaches Association clinic when most people are leaving, and talk to and listen to Cody Francis at Hopkins talk about his single wing package. And it was like the light bulbs went off, and I thought, man, we got to really do this stuff. So I started to do some research on it. I started to feel like it was something I needed to add. And the reasons that that I thought it was such a intriguing thing is, and as I've learned, is that the single wing is a fairly easy offense. I felt it was easy to understand and simple to understand. I thought that it really complemented our schemes very well. I think that it gave our tee package an illusion of having an open set. It allowed us to be a little less predictable with our running game and our passing game. You know, I presented to our kids, and you know, all of a sudden they're standing in shotgun formation, and they're like, "Oh my gosh, this is awesome!" So, you know, my kids think they're in spread every time they line up in single wing, which is kind of fun. Another huge reason why we implemented it was because no one else in our league runs it, and that's one of the things that I sort of think gives you great advantage. If you can do something that your league doesn't do, then, you know, it makes it hard on the other teams to prepare. So, you know, in the Wolverine, at the time, there wasn't a single wing team or anybody that was doing it. And I thought, hey, let's go ahead and let's add this. And then lastly, it's a lot of fun. So some of this, you know, every time we line up in away from our tee and do something different, and the kids get excited about it, and they know, and they're having a lot of fun with it, with some of the misdirection. Now, as far as installing the tee, if it's something that you guys watch this and you go, hey, I'm kind of interested in it, number one, I would tell you, do your homework. Research, clinic up, talk to people that do it. There's a lot of information out there, and I'll share some of that with you at the end of this presentation. Number two, you got to find time to practice it. When we decided to put in the single wing, we spent the entire summer team camp doing it. We decided we were going to commit everything that we needed to do in team camp with it in our offensive periods to add this prep package. And that's a little different for us because we typically use our team camp to kind of, you know, brush the rust off of, you know, our system, and, you know, add our base plays and make sure that our kids really understand it. And we went into summer camp in 2019, and I said, listen, we're not going to do what we normally do, guys. We're going to just be installing this new package. And, you know, I would say start small. In our first, our goal with the single wing was to basically go into our first game with four plays. We wanted to be able to run a sweep power, a counter, and we wanted to be able to pass, throw one pass out of the single wing. And so for us, this was not something that was going to totally change our offensive system. It was just going to be something that was an added wrinkle, but we knew we needed to spend a lot of time doing it, and we knew that we needed to start real small with it. Also very important not to change your verbiage, keep your terminology as close as possible. I think that was a challenge for us because, you know, as I did a lot of research and heard some of the people that talked about how they call things, you know, you've got to do what fits for you. And so, you know, we go ahead and when we want to add a play on a single wing, we want to make sure we don't confuse kids. The other thing I would tell you that is really a must is that you really need to flip your line in this package. You know, you have to have, you know, normally we don't flip our line. We don't have a strong side or a quick side. And I know some offenses do. But when we go to the single wing package, we do that. We go ahead and we flip our line around because it reduces what the players have to learn. And it just makes it easier for them. So those are a couple of things that I would do if you really are serious about implementing any of this stuff. All right, let's move. I'm trying to move on. All right. So the actual single wing set ourselves. Now we do more than what I'm going to show you here. But again, if you have any questions, get in touch with me. So. This is the base set. This is our base set of our single wing package. We have what we call, we use the term west and east. So if we want to be strong to the left, that's going to be a west call for us. And when our kids hear west, number one, they know that they go to single wing. They break away from the tee and they immediately go into their single wing philosophy or mentality. We're going to go ahead and we're going to play tackles on the same side. So we're going to have an outside tackle and we're going to have an inside tackle. And again, those guys are going to flip over. We're going to go ahead and put our quarterback and our halfbacks at shotgun depth. So we're going to take our best running back. And we're going to say, all right, whoever that kid is, you're the halfback. We're going to put our quarterback, of course, next to him. And then we're going to take our fullback, which we're going to call a blocking back. And so, you know, it's labeled a BB there on the slide. He's going to be most of the time our fullback, and he's going to be a guy that's got to be very physical. I mean, you know, he's not the thin, small, tiny type of fullback that some T teams would have there. You need to bring in a bruiser, kind of a blocker kid, you know. You can use an extra guard if you have to, but this is going to be a kid who's really a dominant blocker. And then the wing back, which plays one by one outside the tackle, he is going to be probably your second best runner. So, you know, you got your best runner sitting back by the quarterback, and then you've got your wing back that's probably your number two guy. The blocking back, again, I already talked about kind of the mentality of him and what size needs to be and you know, him being a physical blocker. We play him 1 yard off and we give him a little bit of freedom. You know, we tell him you need to be somewhere between the A gaps and the B gaps. And so he moves around a little bit for us. And we put our guy in a 2-point stance. Some single wing guys will put their guys in a 3-point stance, but we put him in a 2-point. You feel like he can move a little bit better. And splits vary. I tell my guys right now that we go to single wing, that you go to a foot split. But, you know, I've seen other and heard of other programs doing 0 splits or 2-foot splits. I think it really depends on your league, your system, your philosophy. But we're telling our guys about a foot split. But, again, that can vary. Now, the X receiver, who's our split end, we're going to put him at about 4 yards, about a 4-yard split. And that'll vary depending on what we're doing, but that's kind of the default split. So that's the formations themselves. Final thing to talk about is the quarterback and a halfback are splitting. Their inside foot is aligned with the center's foot in front of them. So not one of those guys is directly behind the quarterback. They're both able when the ball's snapped to catch the ball. And we tell our center, You know, you don't have to point or directionally snap. We just want our center to go ahead and shotgun to an area between those two guys. And depending on the play, you know, one of those guys will catch it over the other. So that's our base alignment. This, again, is west. I'll show you east in just a minute. It's going to be flipped the other way. Now, our base offense, our package, on our west formation is, and again, we don't run a ton of plays out of this, but these are basically what we went in the first year and said, hey, we want to be able to run these plays. So, you know, these are our plays. This is what we call them. So we want to run sweep. We want to be able to run off tackle. We want to be able to run trap, counter, reverse, and belly. We have a couple of pass plays off this. Now, I'm not going to go through all of these today, but I am going to go try to get through, if I can, get through counter, because when we went into our first game again, we went into our first game last year, being the first year we even did any of this, we wanted to be able to run those four plays. So these are the plays we concentrated on in camp. Actually, we concentrated on sweep, off tackle, counter, and we didn't put in trap. Trap kind of it came a little later in the season, but these would be the first four plays that I would really encourage teams that are trying to implement this to put in. One more thing I probably should mention before we leave this page is, you know, as far as our terminology, we want to, when we're running strong side, so say we're running left here in a west formation, that'd be our strong side, we will use a number. So if we want to run our sweep, that'd be out here. You know, it'd be to the far left there, out in this area right here. This is our nine gap. This is our nine. So we would say west nine. So we're trying to run our sweep out here in D gap. Five is one hole inside here. So this is west five. If we want to run trap, it would be west one. We actually use the word 31. So it would be west 31 for us as our trap, but this is our one gap right here. If we want to run anything weak side, we don't use a number. We will use a word. It's just easier for our kids to understand that. So if we say west counter, we only have one counter play off of west. Kids know what it is. They know what their rules are. If we want to run weak side, go back here. If we want to run weak side, D gap, that's our reverse play. So we just say west reverse. So it sort of has made sense to our kids that if we use a word, we're running weak side. If we're using a number, we're running strong side. So like west belly, we're going to run over here to B gap weak side. So if I talk that terminology, hopefully you have kind of understanding what I'm mentioning here. All right. This is our east formation. Everything is the same. It's just flipped over. Again, these are the calls that we would have out of east formation, and I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this. You guys can go back and look at that. All right. So I want to go through basically sweep. I want to talk to you about power. And I'm going to talk to you about trap and counter. Now, I am not going to focus in on every little detail of how we block these things because, you know, my whole goal here is to just present this and, you know, you may have some interest in it, you may not. So this is our east formation. And the very first play that we implemented out of this was sweep. And so what you're going to see here is the next page goes through some rules. But basically, we want to run outside here into this alley out and into eight. And our rules for this are as follows. And again, I don't need to go through every one of these. You can go back and look at it. But we're trying to attack that outside D gap. So ball is going to be directly snapped to the halfback, and he's just going to go. You're going to see this on film. And what we are trying to do is we're trying to pin the edge down here. We're trying to get our X receiver to come in here and lock the box, his rules to lock the box. And then we are pulling our blocking back around for force. We're bringing our play side guard around, and we're bringing our quarterback around. So basically, everybody in the world's going around edge. And so it's a tough play to stop. And you see we're pulling 1, 2, 3, 4 guys around the edge, and basically we're giving the ball to the halfback at a running start. And so for a T team like me, you know, you practice against that T, and then all of a sudden we come up in this formation. Hold on here. Gotta get rid of that. All right, sorry about that. We had a little technical problems. All right, so this is basically these next couple slides are going to be running through our sweep play. I'm going to actually escape out of this because I was having some technical problems and enlarge this. All right, so this is a east. This is going to be east 8. You're going to see us pulling around edge. Everybody in the world's coming around the side. And you're going to see a few of these, you know, not every play is going to be a great play, but you're going to see us move forward. I got about a 2-minute clip here, but I might have to. All right. So we're actually going to fumble the ball here, but you're going to see our strong safety come in. He's going to go ahead and he's going to pin inside. You're going to see my wing back here try to double team on the edge. My blocking back is going to be coming right around the edge. And you're going to see the quick guard pulling. And then, of course, we cough the ball up and we fumble the ball in the end zone. It was great. I'll try to give you about 2 or 3 plays on this. This is us playing Vicksburg. Again, you're going to see number 80 here. This is actually a little tweak that we run off of. This is a little tweak that we run off 8 that we call Vice, where our strong safety, instead of coming in here to free safety linebacker area, he actually pins this player, a force player right here, so we kind of get a double team on him. We'll do that if that particular player is physical, and we get around a corner. And, I don't know, a few yard gain. This is gonna be against Edwardsburg. We don't quite get in the end zone here, but we make a pretty nice play. Get down to the 1 yard line. This is, again, you're going to see, again, the big pulls that are going on. And so that's basically our sweep play. I'll show you one more. A tailback spins the ball there. I yelled at him for that on film. Coming around. Don't always bust it outside. Sometimes your halfback's got to come back and cut inside. But that's basically our sweep play. Now here we are, our receiver split end is actually wider. We were doing that basically because of scheme, drawing the corner out a little bit more, but you'll see him still going inside. And then we pull in the guards, we're pulling the tackles around, and nice finish to the run here. All right. So that's our single wing. I'm going to kind of try to speed up through these because of time. This is our 5-6 play. Our 5 and 6 are our off tackle power. Now I will tell you there is a lot of tiny things about this play that are very important. But basically what we want to do is this offensive tackle, when he gets up to the line of scrimmage, he's going to make a blocking call depending on how the defense is aligned. We can block this about 3-4 different ways. But you're going to, for the most part, see our offensive tackle, our inside tackle coming inside and blocking in or base blocking. And this blocking back is going to be kicking force. So when you watch film here, you're going to see this big blocking back coming around most of the time, and you're going to see him punching out someone. That's where we're trying to open up the window. We're going to be pulling our backside guard around like a power play, this, you know, classic T power play coming, pulling the backside guard. And then we are sending our – hold on, let me go back. We are sending our quarterback laterally and up through the gap, and we really want that quick guard, and we want our quarterback to be meeting at the same time and filling the hole. And so hopefully you'll see some of that on film. Now, some of these shots are a little bit mucked up because we're playing against some pretty good teams in some of these clips, but our rules are there. I'm going to skip over the rules right now and just get right to the film. So here is – going on. Playing Marshall here. We're not going to get a ton of yardage on this, but you're going to see we're coming in here. Our blocking back right here is going to come out, and he's going to try to punch on 56 right here on the corner, and you know, we're patient with this. This is in a district. This was in our district final game. And get it to go. So block inside. 56 gets kicked out. You got a bad clip on this. We squeeze up for about 5-6 yards. We got music on this video. So this is a shift that we do out of our single lane. Marshall did a nice job of spilling this outside on that play. We were able to adjust and bounce it out. This is, again, is our sixth play. That's a better shot of us getting inside. Those were all from the Marshall game. Not every one of these games, not every one of these runs is home runs. This is probably the best shot right here. You're going to see on this film right here, we do a really nice job of opening up the window. So I'll kind of end on this one. But as far as the power plays, but you're going to see us come down inside. Again, that blocking back is going to kick out force. Our wing back in this particular play on power, he's supposed to block the next man outside. So he's going to be coming outside here. Our X receiver blocks the box, so he's coming inside, and his on power, he's coming inside. He should be coming inside for free safety, and you're going to see our quick guard and our quarterback kind of meet through the hole here. And this is against Dwajak. I think this is week four. All right, lost my deal here. This one is six. I guess I'll show this one real quick because, you know, this is against Edwardsburg, and this is not a weak football team. So, you know, we feel like putting so many guys through a hole gives us an advantage. Again, this is again against Edwardsburg, probably the same drive. So that is our power play. Winding this down pretty quick here now. The third play that I really feel falls into that T philosophy is trap. And what we're doing with trap here, I'm just going to leave the present off here and just use the scroll here real quick. But this trap play, you know, you tell a T guy what trap is, everybody's knowing what trap is. We're trying to trap the next man past the center. It's a base core play of T football. And so what we realized with a single wing is it was pretty easy to go ahead and run trap out of this. And all you got to do on trap is you just take your halfback, he catches the ball in midair, and now he's through the hole, and it's just as fast as any other trap. Now you do lose deception. Anytime we're running single wing, we don't have as much deception as we would at T. But the nice play about trap is this quarterback is pushing off hard like we're running sweep, and all of a sudden these linebackers start leaving with him. Now we didn't run very many traps most of the time out of single wing. Most of the time, we left our trap game to, our normal T, but we do have a couple of them in here. This particular T ran it. Like I said, we got a couple in here that I'll show you. Again, this is against Vicksburg, pretty good football team. But what you're going to notice on this play is if you take a look at this real quick, notice their inside linebacker. He leaves. He leaves with a quarterback and with a blocking back. So the blocking back's going to leave, quarterback's going to leave. Everybody's thinking this is going outside. And then the halfback just catches the ball, goes right up the pipe. And that's probably the best track that we have. Again, we didn't do too many of these. But next year we're planning on having that be a bigger part of our package. This is – The other one I'll show you against Edwardsburg. Don't get as many yards. I think we picked up about 4 yards here. But you're going to see same thing. You're going to just see everybody leave, trying to get those linebackers to leave with us. And you're going to see, you know, we're fooling this guy right here. We're not so much fooling the backside linebacker. But we're able to get up in there and get about 4 yards. That's a pretty good football team. That is our trap game, all right, as far as out of the single wing. Last thing that I'm going to share with you is counter. This was one of the plays that we wanted to make sure that we had in our summer camp. We felt like if we're able to run sweep, we've got to be able to run counter. And running this is a home run type of play. So with our counter, we have we're going to be pulling three. So you're going to see us be pulling. We're going to pull our quick guard is going to be kicking out force. We're going to pull our outside tackle. He loves this play because it's fun. He gets to pull, so it's something he really gets excited about it. And we're going to be pulling our blocking back around. So basically the rule is the strong guard or the quick guard is going to come out here, kick force or log force. We're going to be having the blocking back comes in second. His rule is inside linebacker, play side linebacker. And then our pulling tackle, our outside tackle, is looking to pick up outside force or pick up any wash that might exist. We're going to run this play. Our normal counter, we're going to go ahead and hand the ball off and directly to the halfback. He's going to do a double, you know, he's going to hand it back off to the wingback who takes a bucket steps and then attacks inside. So this is when we started running this, I don't think we ran it until week three. We didn't even run it for a couple of weeks because we wanted our opponents to see us run and sweep a few times, and then we wanted to come back with counter. So we don't run this for all season long, but when we do, it's starting to pay off pretty big for us. So we will show you a few counter plays. So this is against Otsego. This is going to be, let me jump back on that real quick. This is going to be East counter. So again, we don't use a word or a number here. We're using a word. So you're going to see outside tackle pulling, blocking back pulling, and strong guard pulling. And pretty big gain there. Pretty good patient running back. Most of these are going to be pretty big plays. This one, Otsego, we're playing Otsego. They do a nice job of spilling this. This kid defensively makes a really nice – he makes a nice job over here and spills this. We should be bouncing this outside, but we don't get it out there. Our running back does a nice job of finding the wall and coming back. So that was intended to not go there. Pretty good play adjusting. This is against Edwardsburg. Same thing. This is East counter. Does a nice job of you can see a nice job of our outside tackle pulling there, coming through, cleaning up wash. If you could only block somebody, we'd probably be better off. Nice pull. You saw the kick out here by our strong. This is a nice shot of our strong guard kicking out. Inside linebacker, one guy to beat. Nice game there. Another counter. I think this is against Allegan. This was actually the first game that we ran counter. Nobody had seen us do it on film. So had the advantage of them kind of not expecting it. Okay, this next one is a spin counter. Little adjustment here. You're going to see a little bit different backfield. We'll give it to the quarterback, and he's going to spin. And that's just a variation off of our counter that we run. So we like to run spin counter quite a bit, and we like to throw a spin counter pass off that. Last two I'm going to show you, I think, are reverses. I don't think they're actually. All right, this play right here is actually not a counter. This is our reverse. And in our reverse, what we're trying to do is we're trying to run a hole wider. So instead of us kicking out this man, end man on line, we're trying to log him and get to the outside. But we're still pulling three. And you're going to see just a little different action here. So a little bit more of a reverse look. And I think the last play is also a reverse. I think this is a reverse as well. Nope, that one's counter because we handoffs to the inside. All right, that's going to be all our film. So I'm going to go back here, get this present again. Almost done here. As far as information, you know, if you look at this and you're like, hey, I have some interest in this. Not only can you contact me, but here are some guys that I would contact. Probably the guru of single wing football, at least out there in the clinic world, is Rick Darlington. Rick Darlington is the head coach at Enterprise High School in Alabama, and he has a tremendous amount of knowledge in video, and this guy is a great clinic speaker, and you know, that's his email there. I've talked to him directly, and he's a great football coach, and that's who I would be kind of trying to study under if I had any interest in putting this type of package in. Go look his stuff up. He was a head coach at Apopka Football in Florida for years, and most recently he's moved on to coaching at Enterprise, but he's a guy that you'd want to make sure you get in contact with. Locally in Michigan, I don't know a lot of single wing guys. I haven't been doing it long enough, but Cody Francis at Hopkins is a good resource. He's a guy that kind of got me interested in it. And I know Cody'd be happy to sit down and talk to anybody about single wing football. And then Jeff Scorefor, head coach down at Coldwater. Another T guy that implements the heavy set of single wing is a guy that I've talked to and have got some information from. So, these are some guys I would recommend. And if you know any of them or want to contact them, I think that those guys are great resources. As far as my information, again, it's right there. I have two emails that you can contact. I'm probably going to get to one of them faster than the other. But there's my contact information, my Twitter account, Redskin Nation Football, Tupaw Football. You can follow us. As far as, you know, camp, our camp, at least right now, is planned for July 27th through 30th. We, again, are probably going to spend most of our time this year running our single wing package. It's only the second year implementing that, so I want to make sure that that's really, really something that's smooth. So if you, you're welcome to come down and spend time with us at our team camp if you'd like to, or contact me. I'm sure we can get something set up. So hopefully there's a lot more to it, but if you guys have any interest in that, hopefully you'll give me a call and contact me. I appreciate, again, being able to speak today, and hopefully I've given you something maybe to think about. And stay safe out there, and hopefully we'll be seeing you soon at some clinic or somewhere during the season. All right. Thank you very much.